Good morning. Now I am going to discuss about the judgment AR 2020 Supreme Court 1464 Fair Communication and Consultants versus Surendra Kerdai. In this case, Binami Transaction Prohibition Act Section 3 and 4 was denied. The defense was denied in the promissory suit. Now, I will discuss about the facts of the case. The plaintiff, Surendra, is maternal uncle of the defendant. He was the second appellant before the Supreme Court. The Sanjay, the sole proprietor of first appellant defendant, Fair Communication Consultants, Surendra, filed a suit for claiming recovery of 1,08,000, alleging that Sanjay and his proprietorship firm owned money lent. Surendra was resident of Nasik. So there was some transaction between the parties, and in between, according to the plaintiff, the defendant borrowed a sum of rupees 80,000, but did not pay it. But the defense was that he has paid immediately. The written statement, they have accepted that general power of attorney executed, and thereafter he made arrangement for sale of the property. The defense was deeply not raised before the lower court, but the trial court dismissed the suit for recovery of money. But High Court in his judgment upheld the plaintiff contest that he possessed sufficient amount to advance 80,000 rupees to Sanjay. Therein finally they have allowed the appeal, and a suit was decreed in favor of the plaintiff, directing to pay the amount rupees 80,000 with 6% interest. Here, the appellant before the Supreme Court raised an objection stating that the transaction was illegal because the transaction was under Binami Transaction Act. Therefore, the Supreme Court has said the suit, cause of action arose for suit for money was something different, and the defense is nothing to do with this, with that transaction, because Binami transaction is entirely depends upon the sale of property. Therefore, the Supreme Court has discussed about section 3 and 4. No person shall enter into any Binami transaction. Then, prohibition of right to recover property held by Binami. This is sections says. In Valliyammal versus Legal Aero Subramaniam, this court held that one is establishing the transaction Binami upon who asserted. Assert means claimed. Then there was a guidelines. What was the Binami transaction? How to determine the Binami transaction? The source from which the purchase money came, the nature and possession of property after the purchase, motive if any for giving transaction a Binami color, the position of the parties and relationship if any between the claimant and alleged Binami dar, the custody of the title deeds after the sale, the conduct of the party concerned in dealing with the property. These all are the ingredients to bring any Binami transaction. But finally, the Supreme Court held the Binami transaction was not proved. It was a money suit, therefore he is bound to pay the money. The suit was decreed. The High Court judgment was upheld. appeal was dismissed. If you go through the plaint of Aversan, says the Sanjay, the second respondent, issued 3 checks drawn on the State Bank of India. Since that was not honored, the suit was filed. The written statement was discussed at para 4 of the judgment. Issues were framed. The lower court, there was a difference in the amount received towards the sale consideration, cast doubt regarding the veracity of the plaintiff's claim. So, initially, agreement for sale was executed for some amount, and thereafter sale deed was executed on a different amount, which normally every transaction is being taken place. Therefore, this case may be looked into for recovery of 80,000. The case went on trial for multi number of years, and finally Supreme Court has put an end to the litigation. Thereafter, my humble request is for all advocates, subscribers and followers is that recently the central government in the month of February 2020 issued rules, tribunals, recruitment of tribunals, chairman and vice chairman's rules. That was recently implemented. The notification was 12th February 2020. The rules is called tribunal, appellate tribunal, other authorities, qualification, experience, other condition of service of numbers, 2020. Therein, the entry of advocates as judicial member was permanently not closed, but for several tribunals, door was closed. In some tribunals, they have allowed the advocates to opt for set post along with several other persons. That is very unfortunate. So far as Central Administrative Tribunal is concerned, the rule says advocates are not eligible. But under Section 6 of the Administrative Tribunals Act, the Act provision says the qualification for judicial member was that he is qualified as an High Court judge. If anybody be qualified as an High Court judge, must have 10 years of experience as a practicing advocate. That would be the case. The statute permitted the advocates to opt for judicial member, but the rules prohibited that. So rules should not overcome the statute provisions. Kindly, yes, already before some courts, public interest litigation was filed and interim orders were obtained. And kindly work out this remedy. Apart from that, advocates now we are in race with so many other experts. Kindly go through the rules and work out the remedy. The aspiring advocates recently from Excel, Law of Excellence and other master degrees may not be in a position to locate themselves for this tribunal membership, judicial membership. Now they are going to fill up the post, and they have on 21 they have called for the application so as to reach 5 posts. Kindly do need best wishes. I am not well. Best wishes.